Hi, I'm George from Max Automotive. I want to give you information about 2018 Ford Mustang First Drive Review. California isn't where the Mustang was born, but it might as well be. The Dearborn-bred pony car instantly formed a bond with the sun-kissed state, and Mustangs have been cruising in town or winding through the hills since 1964.5. The affinity is palpable, the roads are good, the weather's fine, and the Mustang's a car that makes you feel good even sitting in prodigious traffic. A perfect match. Since Mustangs can handle now, no surprise there, since the 15-plus Mustangs are the best Mustang ever from a dynamic perspective and the 18 builds off that tradition. Figuring out what makes the 2018 Ford Mustang tick requires the right venue. That's why I'm tearing up and down Latigo Canyon Road in the hills above Malibu. It's early, I have the road all to myself and a choice of Mustang GTs and EcoBoosts, all featuring the optional performance pack. Time to figure out if a new Mustang captures the vibe. I say generally, because I drove three cars with the 10R. Turbocharged engines historically pair well with automatics, so I grabbed a Kona Blue EcoBoost with a new 10-speed. Unfortunately, it felt slow and confused. It didn't hunt, thankfully, but would give a quick, soft judder on top end that drove me nuts. Down and up shifts, with the selector in sport mode and using the paddles, were a bit too slow to be pleasing. It was a real disappointment. I'll chalk it up to abuse inflicted on the poor EcoBoost by others before me, rather than some 10R calibration flaw, but since this is a brand new gearbox for this application, it could take a little while for Ford to dial out such occasional odd behavior. Later, in a different EcoBoost, things were much tidier, and the judder was gone. Likewise with the GT automatic. With tons of torque and lots of gears, I was worried the 10R would trip over itself on Latigo Canyon's more sinewy sections. No gripes on that front. It cruised in normal mode and ripped along in sport, a lot like how the 10-speed performs in the Raptor. Basically, it drives like you'd expect a decent, modern automatic to drive. The real treat is the GT's revised 6-speed manual transmission. The previous car's manual was, let's say, never quite loved by those who drove it. Ford heavily revised the MT-82, and it's all good news. There's a dual mass flywheel and twin disc clutch, which reduces effort and allows the transmission to channel the GT's increased torque. The synchronizers from 1st through 4th are all upsized, which the transmission desperately needed, shifts are smoother and less balky, and effort is way down. It's not quite wrist flick easy like a Miata, but better than before is a monumental understatement. Rather than the slight balkiness of the old box breaking the spell every shift, you can fully immerse yourself in the GT, focusing only on the road. Complete Zen is attainable here. Base price $26,485. As tested price $44,580. All this capability and charisma comes at a price. There's a lot of expensive optional equipment you'll probably want to tack on to either engine option, so base pricing isn't reflective of the car's dynamic excellence. The EcoBoost Fastback starts at $26,485, at about $5,000 to step up to the premium trim, or $5,500 for a convertible. The GT is $35,995, $39,995, and $45,495 respectively. Plop all the best performance bits on the base EcoBoost or GT, and you'll pay $32,675 and $44,580, respectively. As closely specking a Camaro 2.0 T and SS1 as possible, MSRP comes in at $32,395 and $44,995. I've driven the SS1 recently, and it's my opinion that the GT Performance Package car with MagRide and the Howling Coyote engine is simply more engaging to use every day, even if it might lag behind the SS1 using a stopwatch. As always, choose the pony car that speaks to you. The bottom line is that Ford took the best parts of the previous Mustang and enhanced them. That's a conservative play, but a savvy one. And it pays off in the Malibu Hills. Roaring through the canyons in a race-revved GT, when most people are waking up to Folgers, formed this perfect melding of car and setting. California's a long way from Detroit, but the Mustang feels right at home.